I've just arrived at Telegraph Saddle and the car park's full, so we're all parking on the side of the road here. About to set off for the first day to Refuge Cove. It's 9.5 kilometres to Sealers Cove, and I've done it before. I know the track's very well maintained and looked after. Pretty straightforward with some minor hills and a few switchbacks, but nothing serious. This is not the first time I've come across a snake along this trail. On sunny days, they just love to get out and sunbake. So I'm heading towards the campsite at the far end of Sealers Cove, bang on high tide actually. It's taken me about 2 hours to get here, and I'll be wading through waist-deep water, I think, to cross over into the campsite. And the trail to Refuge Cove resumes from there. That is so cool. Well, I've made it to Refuge Cove and the camp is just that way. So I'll set up camp first and then go for a swim. Thank you. So I was about to take one more look at the cove and then hit the trail early, but I changed my mind. It's just so beautiful here at the moment. There's blue skies, a bit of sun, but there's also this cloud rolling in, like a rolling fog. Magic. So you can't have too much coffee, I don't think, so I'm going to have another cup of coffee and just enjoy the morning here before I leave. It was a great night last night. It was cool, about 13 degrees, but dry, so I had a really good sleep. I'm about to hit the trail and walk 7.2 kilometres to Little Waterloo Bay, where I might have a break. We'll see when I get there.
Looks like snakes aren't the only ones out trying to get a little sun.
It's a blue-tongued lizard,
and they're absolutely harmless.
There you have it, that's the round trip to Refuge Cove, back via Waterloo Bay. Hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you get a chance, yeah, definitely get out to the southern prom.